Vision Forward's In Focus team presents.
Hi, this is Luke Scriven here at Vision Forward. Welcome back to another In Focus Tech Talk. In today's Tech Talk, we're going to be taking a look at some useful keyboard shortcuts for Microsoft Edge, which is the web browser built into Windows 10. And if you haven't seen our previous video on the keyboard shortcuts for Microsoft Word, do go ahead and check that out. There should be a link at the top that you can click on to go see that one. And if you do enjoy this video or any of our videos, then please do like and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every Friday on all sorts of different assistive technology and computer topics. So anyway, on with this video, and here we have Microsoft Edge open, and let's go ahead and take a look at some of the useful shortcuts, some which you may know about and some which you may not. So first of all, let's take a look at our magnification shortcut to make web pages larger. This one's nice and easy. We can hold down Control and press the plus key, and each time we press the plus key, we're going to get larger and larger and larger. And most web pages now will wrap as you enlarge them to the width of the screen, and so they will kind of intelligently resize themselves. Control and minus is going to make things smaller again, and we can always use the arrow keys once we have zoomed in to scroll up and down and left and right just by using the up and down and left and right arrow keys. So that's a super easy way for us to navigate around a web page. Okay, let's talk about the next feature, which is going to be our read aloud feature, which we can start with Control Shift U. I'm going to go ahead and switch over to another tab. And here we have a news story. Let's do a Control Shift U, and we're going to start to hear the voice from Microsoft Edge.
Homepage. News. Sport. S. President Donald Trump has completed his course of treatment for COVID-19 and can return to public engagements this weekend.
And the Control Shift U will go ahead and stop that. While it's reading, it will just basically read everything on the page. If we want it to read a specific area, we can just click on that area and it will start to read that specific area. So yeah, very useful, especially for people with a visual impairment. Now let's talk about opening and navigating tabs. So oftentimes we want multiple tabs open depending on what it is that we're doing. And to start a new tab, we can always use Control and T, and that's going to go ahead and open a new tab and take us straight to it. Once we have multiple tabs open, we might want to be able to navigate those more easily than clicking on them with the mouse. And luckily we can do this with a Control and Tab. So hold down Control, and each time we press Tab, it's going to move us through to another tab, and it will just keep on cycling through those. And then we've decided that we want to close one of these tabs, and luckily we can do that with a Control W, and that's going to go ahead and close out that tab for us. All very useful stuff, I'm sure you will agree. Now, we might want to add a page to our favorites list, and obviously adding things to our favorites list is a very nice way just to keep us organized and make sure we have easy access to the most commonly used websites. And to add a page to our favorites, we can just go ahead and hit Control D, and that's going to bring up the kind of add to favorites box here, where we can give the web page a name. It will automatically name it, but we can rename it if we want. And once we've done, we can just go ahead and press enter. And now that's been saved to our favorites list. Very handy indeed. And of course, oftentimes with a website, we might want to go backward and forward, or with a web page rather. In our browser, we might want to go backward and forward. So let's open up a new tab here, and I'm going to do a search for cheese. And here we go, we found our results for cheese here. But I've just realized that I want to go back because I don't want to search for cheese. I just want to be in my on my homepage instead. So I'm going to go ahead and hold Alt and press the left arrow. And that's going to be our back command, Alt, left arrow. And now I just realized, oh wait, I actually did want to search for cheese after all, but rather than researching for it, I'm just going to go forward. So hold Alt and press the right arrow, and that's going to move us forward, which is all very useful indeed. Now we can also choose to go home at any point to our home page, whatever that might be, at any point. And that's going to be done with an Alt and Home. So that one's not too hard to remember. Hold down Alt and press Home, and it will take us back to our home page, which in this case I've just got the regular Microsoft home page here. All very useful things indeed. If we want to close out our web browser, then we can go ahead and press an Alt F4. That will work with any window in Windows. So Alt F4 to close, but let's go ahead and minimize it instead. And again, this will work with any window. I'm going to hold down the Windows key and press the down arrow. First time I do that, it will kind of make the window smaller. Second time I do it, it will minimize it completely. And if I want to maximize that window again, so let's go ahead and bring that window up again. And at the moment, because we had made it smaller previously, it's not filling the whole screen. So let's hold down the Windows key and press the up arrow. And that's gone ahead and maximized that window for us. And lastly, but definitely not least, is how do we quickly get back to our search bar, our search and address bar? Well, that's nice and easy. We can do an Alt D. And so from wherever we are, so let's see here. Let's say that I'm down on this LinkedIn icon down here, for example. But I suddenly realize, I want to go to the search and address bar and enter a web address. Rather than moving the mouse up there and clicking there, we can go ahead and do an Alt D, and it's going to put us right into that search and address bar. Then we can just go ahead and type whatever it is that we want to search for and press enter. Well, I hope you enjoyed listening to these different keyboard shortcuts. Obviously, they can be very useful for people with a vision impairment, because it just makes it easier to navigate around rather than having to rely on the mouse or, you know, magnification or anything like that. But obviously, they're also useful for people who are not vision impaired as well, because they just, you know, make things a lot quicker. So learning a few keyboard shortcuts and you'll be a master of computers before you know it. If you want to know more about this or any assistive technology topic, then you can get in touch with us. You can call 414-615-0103. You can send us an email, infocus@vision-forward.org. And you can visit our website at vision-forward.org. As I said at the start of the video, if you do enjoy it, please do like and subscribe. It really helps the channel out. And we do release new videos every Friday. And with that said, we look forward to seeing you in the next video.